Okay, so just mute your microphone, everyone. Okay, if you have any questions, I'll take in the end, guys. Okay, I'm Hari Krishna. Okay, so I will be taking the sessions from today. And coming to this Pega PRPC tool. Okay, so Pega PRPC is just an application development tool. So where we can develop web applications without writing any coding in this tool. Okay, so it is also called as a BPM tool. Okay, Pega PRPC is also called as a BPM tool, or we can also call it as a Java based application. It is also called as a Java based application. So why it is a Java based application means this total PRPC tool is designed using Java coding only. Means it is developed in J2EE environment. So that's the reason. So Pega is also called as a PRPC, or we can also call it as a Java based application. Okay, but when we work on this Pega PRPC, so we will not write any coding or anything. Okay, just a tool is a Java based application. Okay, in the back end, Pega only will automatically generate the code, and it will generate the functions and everything in the back end. But when we work on any application, right, Pega PRPC application, so there is no need to write any coding here. Okay, so entire thing will be drag and drop and point and click. Means anything you want to develop inside this Pega PRPC tool, all the things are integrated in the tool itself. Okay, so many internally when we install the Pega software, so what are all the wizards and tools will be internally integrated in the Pega tool itself. Okay, so only thing is, so how to map the rules inside the Pega PRPC we'll be learning in this training process. Okay, so you'll not write any coding, or no need to create any new methods here, or no need to create any new libraries or functions. So everything is inbuilt in the tool only. So how to use them in order to develop applications, you will be learning in this training process. Okay, so first of all, coming to the Pega PRPC, right? So Pega is just a product name. Okay, Pega is nothing but the name of the product. So it is a product of Pega Systems actually. So Pega Systems is the owner of Pega. So they don't have any other products. Pega is the only product they are having. And coming to PRPC, so I'm calling it as a Pega PRPC, right? So in this PRPC called as a, so the full form is Pega Rules Process Commander. So here, so what is this PRPC means? It is a platform. So which is used for designing applications and deploying the applications. So inside this tool or inside the application, so PRPC is the name of the platform which is used to design and deploy the applications. And I'm also calling it as a BPM tool, right? So BPM is nothing but a methodology used by Pega Systems. It is a suit, we can call it as a BPM suit, or we can call it as a methodology. So which is implemented in the back end by the Pega Systems. Okay, so combinedly Pega PRPC BPM is a, we can call it as a tool, or we can call it as a application. Okay, and inside this Pega PRPC BPM application, so we can develop new applications, we can design, means we can do support applications, we can work on maintenance applications, we can integrate with different applications. Okay, so different companies uses this tool for different purposes. Okay, so first of all, so coming to the overview of this Pega PRPC tool, okay, we'll be having a small PPT on this. So generally Pega is developed, means it started as a middleware tool, guys. Okay, in the early stages. So at this early stages, it is not a development tool. It started as a middleware tool, and later, so they did so many changes to that, and currently it is used as a application development tool. And this Pega PRP is used in so in all the sectors like banking applications, finance applications, healthcare, okay, communications, media, life sciences. So maximum, so it supports every domain in the market. So and also in this Pega PRPC, so what are the things? It is a Java based application at all. Means what are the things possible in Java, same thing we can do in Pega also. But in Java the process will be different, but in Pega the process will be different. But the same thing, what are the things using Java programming language, whatever you can do, same thing we can do in Pega also, but here the process will be different. Okay, so here the process will be different when we compare with the Java programming language. But the what are all the same things, same what are the applications we can develop in Java, same type of applications we can also develop in Pega also. So the only difference will be, so here the tool will be, so all the options are internally integrated within the tool. Okay, so no need to additionally so add any new methods or new things, no need to add. So using those internal options and integrated things, so we can develop new applications inside this tool. Okay, so in detail, so what is this Pega PRPC BPM means? So generally this Pega is not a freeware guys, generally it is a licensed version. Okay, so anybody or any client or any company want to use this product, and in order to develop any applications, so they need to get license from Pega Systems. Okay, Pega Systems is the owner, right? So any company want to use this product in their companies or what, so they need to get license from the Pega Systems. Okay, and so when they get the license, so based on the license they can get the access, the server access from the Pega Systems, and they can work on Pega PRPC applications. Okay, so in this I told you Pega is just a product name, and PRPC full form is Pega Rules Process Commander. So this Pega rules are nothing but libraries. Okay, generally in Java terms we used to call as libraries, in Pega terms, in Pega terminology we used to call them as rules here. Okay, means inside the, so all the things like classes, functions, methods, okay, libraries, everything are pre-configured in this Pega rules. Okay, so I told you everything is internally available in the tool. So using those Pega rules, so we can create new things in the application and design the applications. And process commander is a storage area, means so within this tool, like I told you, one platform, PRPC acts as a platform. So inside the platform, in order to store all the predefined things, so it is a layer or pre-configured layer, so which provides a foundation on which, so where we can develop new applications and customize the new applications. So this overall PRPC is nothing but a, so we can call it as a platform or a portal in order to deploy applications and design the applications. And BPM is a smart BPM, which is also called as a smart BPM or BPM suite, so which is available by the, means which is used by the Pega Systems in order to manage the business process and in order to manage the workflows and monitor the connections, means so connections means so between internal applications and external applications, so in order to create connections and all, so they will use this BPM suite. Okay, it is like a methodology used by the Pega Systems in order to manage the workflows and in order to improve the performance of the applications, so they will incorporate this smart BPM methodology. Okay, and in detail, so what this PRPC will do means inside the Pega PRPC tool, so it is a platform which is used for building and deploying all any type of applications. Okay, and in the backend, what this PRPC will do means, so it will automate our work and automate our programming. So here nothing is done manually within this tool. Okay, so all the things are pre-configured, and whatever the inputs we are providing inside these rules, so it will automate our work and automate the programming. So PRPC will automates the work and automates the programming, and using this PRPC platform, we can develop any type of applications without writing any coding in the PRPC tool. Okay, so that is the purpose of PRPC platform. And in detail, what is the BPM means? So it is a methodology which helps to manage the process and workflows in the organizations. Okay, so within the organization, so in the back end already, so no need to install it separately. So it comes with as a Pega software. Okay, and with this help of this BPM, so in the back end it will manage the workflows and also it will create connections, means the day-to-day operations will be managed by this business process in the back end. And in detail, so what are the things business process will do means, so it will control how business is conducted in the applications and defines the data and the flows, means it defines the data and information between the flows, and it will create a connections between different people, means between individuals, means between the people internally, means within the organization, means so within the internal applications and external applications. So all the connections between these things will be managed by this business process. Okay, so overall, so what are the things BPM will do means, BPM will incorporate planning, designing, building, operating, maintaining and improving the business process within the applications. And coming to the advantages of this smart BPM, so compared to traditional programming languages, so if they use this Pega PRPC product, so we can develop applications in a faster way. So for example, one application you want to develop in .NET or Java, okay, same applications we can also develop in Pega. So the time taken in other programming languages will be like 2 years, means same application we can compute in within 1 year in Pega PRPC tool, because so here everything is predefined, right? So no need to start from scratch. So already we have all the things, functions and everything, methods, everything is integrated. So directly we can pass the inputs and we have some tools to create all the rules easily. And the development time will be very less. The production cost will be very less here. And the overall IT cost, manpower, everything will be very less here. Okay. So with what are the things we have inside the BPM, so we can, so manage means the overall production cost and development time will be very less when we compare to any programming language. Okay, and also the performance wise and security wise, so we have more advantages in this Pega PRPC BPM. Okay, and coming to other things, so BPM contains some different types of components, or we can say some rule types will be there. So using these rule types, we can develop so any type of complex applications. Okay, some of the components we have inside this BPM applications is like user interface, data model, data storage, business logic, process, integrations, reports, okay, system admin, organization. So many types of components will be there. So we have to combine, means individually we'll create separately each rule separately, and we'll combine one rule with other rule, and combining all these things, so where we can create complex applications, any type of complex applications, so based on any domain we can develop inside this Pega PRPC BPM tools. And compared to other things, like if you compare any other BPM tools in the market or other programming languages in the market, so Pega is right now the number one tool in the market. So and Pega is basically built on Java, I told you, right? So Pega application is built on Java, but and it will produce Java code behind the scenes, and no need to use coding here. Okay, so just it will produce a code behind the scenes. Okay, just we can view them, no need to modify that or no need to do any changes in the coding here. So automatically, so it will automate the work and it will automate the programming. Pega will automate our work and it will automate our programming. And main goal of Pega is to eliminate the coding from scratch, and it want to automate the manual work to the minimum and build complex applications. So and they are successful into, so this eliminate the coding and automating the work. Okay, and other advantages will be like, so using this Pega, so the overall, we discussed, so the overall production cost and the manpower and development time is very less. Okay, and Pega is also called as a build for change product. Okay, so generally, so what are the changes happening in the industry? So IT or anything, so all the things will be implemented in latest versions. Okay, so all the features wise, so every time they will update the versions every 2 years or 3 years. So whenever they update the version, so what are the latest things happening in the IT? So they will update everything inside the tool also. Okay, so currently latest version is Pega 7 version. Okay, so I will tell the differences between the versions also. So compared to the previous versions, so in the latest version so many changes has been happened. Okay, but the core concept is same, but only thing is some 4 to 5 rules has been changed and the look and feel of the tool is changed. The overall concept is same in all the tools, but when you compare the previous version, that is 6.3 version, to 7.1 latest version, so here the only changes is some 5 rules has been changed and the look and feel of the tool is changed, that's it. So remaining the core concept and what are the things we used in 6.3, same things we use in 7 also. Okay, so just from few rules, okay, few controls and few things are newly included in the latest version. So those things anyway we'll cover in the practical sessions. And coming to the advantages of this Pega PRPC, so we here I told you, so again you can build solutions in a faster way using the complete platform, and we can build in a smarter way, no need to think more on the coding wise. Okay, so coding wise Pega will take care, so we have to think on the, no need to think much on the logic wise. Okay, and work with different systems, so build response and social applications, so bring system together, means integrate with different applications. And Pega contains forums and PDM communities will be there, so any issues we can discuss with, so overall, so PDM means globally, so there will be forum, community will be there, so any suggestions if you want to, so we can post in the community and we'll get the answers immediately. Or else Pega also contains a support team will be there, so where they can set any time 24/7, so on any topic if you have any questions or any doubts, so we can contact the support team. So when you work on the real time, okay, so there will be support team, so always available. So any issue, suppose if you don't know how to do this task, so they will be available to help you at any time. So like this, so the developers wise, so that means the work will be easy for the developers. So when we compare with, so any other programming language, so the work will be easy for the developers here. And coming to, means in the market we have so many tools are there, like other BPM tools, so Oracle, Lombard, IBM contains some 50 to 60 tools are there, so TIBCO, but in this most of the tools are middleware tools. Okay, so in this most of the tools are middleware tools, but Pega, it is also a middleware tool, and apart from that, so many other functionalities and features are incorporated in the Pega PRPC. But if you compare with any other BPM tool in the market, so Pega will be in the standard, means it stands in the top position. Okay, so Pega don't have any competition in the BPM market or any other programming domain also, you don't have any competition to Pega PRPC. So currently it is top in the market and hot in the market. And coming to the just architecture, means here, so first of all, basically Pega supports OS operating systems like Windows, Linux and Unix. Okay, you can work, you can install and you can work on any of this OS. And when we install this Pega software, so along with the Pega setup, we can install three things. Okay, that is, so automatically by default, so database gets installed, Java JDK will install, and application server will get installed. Okay, so these three comes as a package, so based on the OS, so any type of OS we can use. And coming to the architecture, total architecture, so database, application kit and application server will be, so installed along with this Pega software. Okay, so it will not install separately, all these three comes as a package here. And one more thing is, Pega supports all the databases in the market and all application servers in the market. So not only this, so what are the databases mentioned here, not only this, there are so many other databases, or what are the database we have in the market, it is supported by Pega systems, means based on the client requirement, so they will go with the database and server. Okay, but again Pega contains two editions will be there, one is personal edition and another one is enterprise edition. Okay, so only difference between the personal edition and enterprise edition is, so generally the tool and options will be same in both the editions. So only difference will be in personal edition, so by default Pega will provide one database and one application server. Okay, so we cannot select our own database and server in personal edition. So along with the version, if you take 7.1, so by default along with the setup, so we will get one database and one server we will get. Okay, so but in enterprise edition, based on the client requirement, so they can select the database and select the server. Okay, but there will not be any difference, because so in Pega PRPC there is no need to have any database knowledge and application server knowledge. So they will install in the backend along with the setup. If you work on, for example, so right now in the default version, it will install PostgreSQL SQL database and Tomcat server. In the real time, even if you work on SQL or DB2, IBM DB2 database also, the processor will be same here, because for database mapping and all, we will use some predefined methods we will use, which is common for all the databases. Okay, anyway, I will show you in the next session. So here, what are the database we use, right? So any database if you use in the real time also, the procedure will be same and the methods will be same for all the databases. And application server also, so based on the size of the applications, they will go with the servers here. Okay, so if you want the banking applications, means they can go with WebSphere or WebLogic. Okay, depends upon the size of the applications and all. Okay, so no need to have any application server knowledge also. And just JDK will install in the backend, because just this Pega is a Java based application. So for that, so it, in order to generate the code automatically in the backend, it will install Java JDK version also. Okay, so these are all the things it will install when we install this Pega PRP software in our systems. And later, so all the applications will be saved as a framework. I will tell you about the framework in the next sessions. So when we start the application setup, then we can discuss about this and what are all the different types of domains and different types of applications we can develop. So communication domains, energy, financial services, healthcare, banking, insurance, life sciences, manufacturing, public sector. Okay, so these are all the different types of domains. So where Pega is having, means Pega is providing the business. And some of the new features incorporated in the new version is, so maybe some terminologies we will not know, so I'll just tell the points. So these features I'll discuss in the practical sessions. Okay, something is look and feel of the total tool is changed, and current version supports all the browsers, and current version contains live user interface, means all the things are dynamic layouts will be there, means we can also call as dynamic user interface in the latest version. And something like UI responsiveness, means some UI user interface components has been modified. So warnings and split schema is some of the new things included in the current version. And pinned classes is newly added in the one. It is just a simple option. Means if you want like a bookmark thing, if you want to bookmark any class, so we can add to the pinned classes list. And zero downtime, even so the data will be running in the backend or updates, it will automatically update in the backend if you even the server gets down or whenever we go to upgrade the database. So there will be zero downtime will be there. And application express, which is used for designing applications, means whenever you want to create a new application setup in PRPC, so there is a new tool is included in the current version. And we have a new concept called stages and data pages. And dynamic layouts is newly included in the latest version. Guardrails are also newly included in the, means guardrails are already there and some new guardrails has been added in the latest version. Okay, these are some of the new features, and few features has been deprecated in the previous version, means some features has been deleted, means so what are the features, some features we use in 6.3, so those are deleted and some new features are added in the 7 version. So those differences and all you will get in the coming sessions. So after 2 week sessions, so then you can understand the just concept on Pega 7. then I will tell the differences between the 6.3 version and 7 version. So right now you cannot understand all the things. So once after completing few sessions, then I will tell the differences between the versions. Okay, these are all the list of versions. So the previous versions and all. So 7.1, 6.3, 2.1, 5.5, 5.4, 4x, 3x, 2x, like this. So these are all the list of versions. Okay, so currently only any support projects or maintenance projects are there, means they will be using 6.3. So very rare companies. So and most of the companies, not most of the companies, so maximum 80%, more than 80% of the companies will use 7.1 version. So if you learn 7.1, you can easily work on 6.3 also. But if you learn 6.3, we cannot work on 7.1. Okay, so anyway, the differences and all, and what are the rules we have difference. So we'll be having sessions on 6.3 also, two sessions. So in that session we'll cover all the differences and all the controls. And coming to the installation wise, so the system requirements, minimum system requirements are, so we can install this Pega 6.10 7 versions in any OS. Like, so mostly we'll be having Windows, right? So whether it is Windows 7, 8, 8.1 or 10 also, Pega supports. Okay, so we can install this Pega in any Windows operating system, whether it is Windows 7, Windows 8 or 10 operating system, and make sure it must be 64-bit OS. Okay, so not 32-bit. So make sure you are having 64-bit operating system, and minimum RAM size is 4 GB, and minimum space required is 15 to 20 GB free space is required. Okay, so with this minimum system requirements, so anyone can install this Pega software. Okay, and coming to the, I told you, so when we install the Pega setup, right, so and we will be installing the personal edition, which is a full version. I am going to share the software setup file. So once you have to download the file and keep it, and once if you install the software, it will be for a lifetime. It's not like a trial version or anything, or limited version. So once if you install the personal edition also, it will work for lifetime. And along with this personal edition, so when if you want to install this setup, so it will install one database, a server, and Java JDK version. So these three install as a package. In one folder it will create all this setup, and you will install as a package. Okay, not separately. So all these things will be installed as a package. And coming to the database in 7.1 version, PostgreSQL SQL is the database, and server in all the personal editions, Tomcat is the default server, and JDK 1.1 version it will install. Suppose if anybody is having JDK like 1.8 is also available. If anybody is having Java JDK 1.8, before installing this Pega software, if you are having higher version than 1.7, means then uninstall the latest version, and once if you install the Pega software, you can install again. Okay, just in installation steps and all, once again I will tell you in another session, next session. So just I am saying, if you have a higher version of Java more than 1.7, that is 1.8 if you are having, means once uninstall before installing this Pega PRPC. Okay, so generally these three things will get installed with this personal edition. But in the enterprise edition, so what are the database the client require and what are the server client require, they can select any database and any server, and Pega supports all databases and servers in the market. Okay, but in the personal edition, so by default along with the version, they will configure one server and one database only. So this is the default server, and this is the PostgreSQL is the default database, and the procedure is same. Even though if you use in the real time, if you use different server and different databases, the procedure is same. So that's the reason there will not be any difference between the personal edition and enterprise edition. The options will be same. So internally if you open the tool, so the same thing will be there in the personal edition also. Okay, but enterprise edition will be used in the companies. Personal edition, so also we can develop applications and deploy applications. So but it is a free version, and once if you install, we can work for lifetime. Okay, and along with this personal edition. So means once we install the setup of this personal edition, right, it is going to create some icons in the desktop. So just installation will take around 30 to 35 minutes, and once the installation is done, it will create the icons in the desktop like this: login icon, shutdown icon, and startup icon. Okay, these three icons will get created, and generally here the server is intranet server. So what are the Tomcat server it is installing, right? So here it is a intranet server, means no need to connect to any external system. Enterprise edition means so they will connect to the Pega system's external server, but here connecting to external server is not required. So directly whenever you want to use the application inside your means if you want to use the application means or if you want to open the application in your systems, so just start the server. Tomcat server will start, and which is intranet server. Okay, and no need to have any internet connection if you want to use this Pega PRPC tool. Okay, so whenever you want to use this application, you have to start the server. If you click on the startup icon, so it will start the server automatically. Actually in my system server is already started. So these two windows will open. The startup icon if you click means, so these two command prompts will open, and in my system already server is started. Okay, application server is already started. So if you click on the login icon, and this application will open in a browser that is inside Internet Explorer or any other browser. Okay, it will open in Chrome, it will open in Mozilla, it will open in Safari, any browser Pega supports. Okay, but previous version means it will work only in IE browser, but current version it supports all the browsers. So but recommended is Internet Explorer browser. Okay, so for best usage, and if you want to open all the rules and all the options, so IE is the best one. Okay, so maximum go with the means directly use Internet Explorer as a default browser whenever you want to use the application. And Pega contains a user ID and password. So once we start the server, and after clicking on the login icon, so we need to enter the username and password, and Pega will provide a, so anybody install the software for the first time, right, so you need to log into the application, then only we can create a new setup, new application setup. So in order to so log into the application, Pega will have a default user ID and default password. Administrator@pega.com is the default user ID, and password is INSTAWL is the password. Okay, so we can log into the default application, means we can log into the application using the default username and default password. And later, so once after logging to the default application, so we need to create a new application setup, because in the default operator ID we cannot build a new project. If you want to start building a new project, means we need to start a new application setup. So we have to create our own application setup, then based on the application name and organization name, we can create our own operator IDs, our own user IDs. Okay, inside the own user IDs, we'll start building the new application. Okay, in the default ID, so only we have to create a new setup. Okay, so once the application setup is generated, we will log out from the default ID and we'll log in using our own operator IDs. Okay, so that application setup configuration, so I'll tell you in the next session. Okay, just log into the application. So the default ID is administrator@pega.com, and install is the password INSTAWL. And once we install this Pega, right, everything is integrated in the tool itself. Okay, apart from this, there is no need to install any other softwares. Okay, all the widgets, all the tools, all the options, everything is integrated in the tool itself. Okay, so if you have anyone having any idea in about previous versions, so if you compare with the previous version, here the look and feel of the 7 version will be totally different here. Okay, the look and feel is totally new when I compare with the previous version. Okay, So generally previous versions you don't have all these options. So many options are newly included in 7 version. So I will discuss in the sessions, okay, when we start the practical sessions. So then I will cover the things. So again, about the tool, about the options, so what are all these menus and what are all these explorers and what are all the footer options. So everything we'll discuss in the next session, okay. And meanwhile, so this training will be for 30 to 35 hours, and in the training process you'll be getting the Pega 7.0 software, 6.3 software, and all the training recordings. So session recordings you'll get for every session. So documents and notes. Now I'm going to share the certification dumps also. So for CSA only you'll get the dumps. For CSSA you have to prepare by your own. I'll be sharing the materials for that. But for CSA certification you'll get the dumps. Okay, resume preparation will be there. So I'll give the projects. You have to select the resumes and send it to me. So I'll update the resume also. Okay, so assistance, interview assistance will be there. Interview questions and all I will share. Okay, from my side you'll get all these assistance. And the next regular sessions will start from Tuesday, 6 a.m. IST. So coming means today is Friday. So Tuesday, 6 a.m. IST, Indian Standard Time. And for our US students, it will be Monday evening for you. For US students, it will be Monday evening. So for Indian students, so from Tuesday, 6 a.m. IST, the batch will start. Okay, from daily it will be there. So generally, sessions will be Monday to Saturday or Monday to Friday it will be. So maximum 5 to 6 days a week it will be there. So sometimes I'll take on Saturday also. Except Sunday, we'll be having sessions from Monday to Friday or Monday to Saturday. Okay. So now I will take questions from one by one. Everyone don't speak. So one by one I will be taking the questions. First one is, just wait for a second. I will tell the names. You can ask me the questions. So somebody joined with the name Android attendee. May I know the name of yours? Okay, Prasad. Okay, full name? Okay, CVN Prasad. Okay, fine. Okay, any questions, Prasad? Okay. Yeah, actually Pega, first of all, 60% of the product, more than 60% of the Pega projects from Hyderabad location only. Okay, if you compare most of the Pega companies and Pega partner companies located in Hyderabad only, then only the remaining 40% in Bangalore and Pune are there, Chennai, Bangalore or Pune. And 60% of the projects and companies are from Hyderabad location. So most of the jobs are from, any Pega jobs from in India will be from Hyderabad only. And so in order, and okay, one more thing, and for learning this Pega PRPC, right, no need to have any prerequisite skills. So basic OOPS concepts and Java, basic OOPS concepts like basic OOPS concepts and basic query in SQL knowledge is sufficient, guys. Okay, and minimum, if you want to, so Java means not advanced Java, just a basic core Java, like what is class, what is inheritance, so what are OOPS concepts, so that one I will cover in the sessions, don't worry. So packages you'll get, okay, relevant experience 3, that one you'll get around 9 to 10 lakhs. But when you want to go first time, if you want to move from other domain, right, so just go with the less package also, because you can also go, you must go with 8 lakhs also, you have to go, because okay, that's what I'm saying. You will get, suppose if you have a confident, means you can, so confidently answer all the questions, means you can also, after 1 year experience, you can also ask 13 or 14 lakhs also you can ask. But if you want to get in for this, if you want to change the domain, right? So at that time, first time we have to go with the less package only. And after 1 year experience, you can demand anything. So that's what this Pega professionals will do. So if you, once after working for 6 months or 1 year, you can demand like more than 50% also you can demand. Because so many technologies will be, right now they don't have much demand for other technologies like mainframes and all. So what they will do means, so they will switch to Pega, and then once after working for few months or few years, like 1 year or like that, so then they can demand anything. But because, so if you want to get in or change the domain means, at the starting time you have to go with the less package only. Okay, so you can ask for maximum 10 lakhs you will get here. So with this experience, yeah, in this sessions we will cover all the real-time scenarios. So all the sessions are practical sessions only. So only 2 or 3 sessions, so basic introduction about all the rules will be there. And from then, so we'll be taking a small domain, and then we'll cover all the scenarios. Means we'll be covering all the rules in Pega PRPC. Okay. Next, Chanakya, any questions? Okay, so you're from India or US? Okay, fine. So you're pursuing your MS or what? Completed? Okay, fine. Okay, any questions on this? Okay, it's sufficient. Okay, if you don't have any SQL knowledge or any basic core Java knowledge, also not an issue. So you can easily learn the SQL on some sites are there. W3 schools and some sites are there. So just a basic, not advanced SQL is not required. So anyway, we'll be using the predefined methods only. Coding also we will not define. But in interviews, they'll ask for SQL knowledge. So that's what reason you have to prepare that one. Okay. Next, Chandrasekhar, any questions? Okay. Pega maximum, so 50% of the jobs will be on banking and healthcare, and remaining, so 50% of the jobs will be on remaining financial, marketing, public sector, so insurance sector. So it depends. So what are the requirement company has? So they can take on any domain. Okay. So whether you work on any domain, the process will be same. Yeah, one sample project, it will cover all the scenarios, all the domains. Means it will, because see here, the we'll be learning the process. So what are the domain, it may be the procedure will be same. So we'll be concentrating on the technically how to use the rules in the application, how to implement them in the application. Okay, so it will be helpful. So you can work on any domain. So once after the learning this training, so not only in banking or healthcare or anything, so you can work on any other domain. Okay, if you have CSA and CSS, it's sufficient. So CSA, so first of all, before that there will be CSA certification will be there. Certified System Architect, Certified Seniors. Okay, once ask them to meet my others, your colleagues, somebody is there, just to meet my, or else you meet a microphone, I will tell you. Okay, there will be CSA first of all, that is the first level certification, Certified System Architect. And then we'll be having Certified Senior System Architect, CSSA. Okay, if you have those two, it's sufficient to apply for a job and get. Okay, but maximum you can go with CSA. If you want, if you are interested, you can also complete CSSA also. Okay, then. Okay. Yeah, both are. No, no. LSA is the next level to CSSA. So CSSA is the second level, and LSA will be third level. Okay. So then this training is sufficient for both CSA and CSSA. But LSA means we have to do a project by your own. Okay, that one. Once you get into the job, then you can do. So LSA contains again two modules will be there, LSA 1, LSA 2. So that one, once you get into the job, you can do those things. Means, so that one also upon your interest only. Suppose if you want to more pay, so compared to other developers, so based on the certifications, whatever you have, you'll be getting a better package. Okay, but currently India CSA is sufficient, and in US also if you keep more than 4 years means CSSA is required. Okay, or if you keep less than 4 years experience, then CSA is sufficient, and if you keep more than 3 years or 4 years, so you can go with the CSSA exam. Okay, so this will be okay, the topics will be same. What are the topics I cover in CSA and CSSA will be same. In CSA certification, you will get only theoretical questions. And here, mixed will be. Some theoretical and some scenario based questions will be there in CSSA exam. CSA will get the dumps. And CSSA, so what are the my sessions, my material and some Pega PDN, some Pega help file material will be there. If you prepare that material, you can, means once after completing all the practicals in the sessions, so you can also clear CSSA also. Just tell me, I can. Email. Okay, suppose if you want, means any email support, so between session to session I'll give a email support, or if you make any call I can support, or else, so if you want to wait, you can wait for the next session. So until if you wait, so then after the starting of the session or ending of the session, doubt session will be there, 22 minutes to half an hour. So then if you have any doubts on the session, you can ask. So after the training, so job support we'll have separately. So for that charges will be there. Okay, that one we can discuss later. Yeah, after the course also every week I can take a review class. Every 1 week if you want. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Next, Gopal, any questions? Yeah, hi. Yes, still. Any questions, Gopal? It's common for any Java based, not only BPM, they can use in any Java based applications. But no. Okay, means if you compare, means in the same category or from a different domain. So same category. Okay, same category means right now we have like Lombardi is there and Oracle BPM is there, but they are not the features wise, and when we compare with the Pega PRPC tool, so the options and features are not as per the Pega PRPC tool. Okay, so they are there, but compared to the BPM, so they are far behind these two. Okay, so but this market, Pega market, will be there for next 15 to 20 years, don't worry. So it is currently, because it stands top in the last 3 to 4 years. So in the, if you see the Gartner report and all, so Pega is hot in the market, and it is the best BPM tool in the current market. Yeah, maximum Okay, maximum 80% of those financial insurance companies will be using Pega PRPC only. Yeah. Okay, next. Iqbal, any questions? Yeah, Java, just tell me. Okay. Okay. That's it. Yeah, because so first thing is no need to have any. Yeah, everyone, so many will move from mainframe to Pega, not an issue. It will be very easy. Okay, how many overall experience you have? Mm, 14 years means you have to try like a developer role or like system architect role, you cannot try. Try for a business analyst role. It will be helpful for you. Okay, this training will also cover some more than 50% of the business analyst part also. So you can switch as a business analyst. So there will be certification, CBA certification. So if you complete that one, you can attempt, it means you can put a profile for the business analyst. So you can switch easily, not a problem. Oh, no need to have any prerequisites. No, that's what I told you. No need to have any prerequisites for this. So anyone from any background can learn. Yes. Okay. If anybody missed the session, they'll be getting the recording, class recording of that session. Anyway, so if you join or not join, daily you'll be getting the recording. Okay, next, Mohan, any questions? Yeah, I can hear you. Okay. Yeah, no, not an issue. Okay. Mac, we can means personally. Okay. Oh, no. Suppose in Windows, not only Windows, Unix and Linux. So if you want to use in a Mac operating system, you can install a VMware, third party VMware, and inside that you can install Windows, and in Windows you can install this Pega PRPC. Okay. Yeah, Kenda market is also good for Pega. Not an issue. It will be sufficient. Like 3 to 4 years you can keep on Pega. Relevant experience. Okay, retail marketing also we have. Yeah, some few retailers are also working on Pega PRPC. They are using, some clients are there. So you can keep one project, and other projects you can keep on any finance. Yeah, domain specific knowledge means I'll give the like documents I'll do, because this training it will cover all the domains, so not only single domain. So the procedure and scenarios will be related to all the domains. Okay, like $155. Okay, if you practice continuously, like so 1 month to 45 days it will be sufficient. Okay, you can. Yes, tell me. Employment, I will give the. If you want, I can give the consultants' contacts in US and Canada. You can contact them. So they will give the placement assistance. Right? Okay, fine. So Australia also not a problem. So but Australia you have to look after. US means US and Canada means I can give the consultants contacts. So they have so many companies and they can place you. Okay. On weekend classes not there. Only on weekdays, Monday to Saturday. Okay, 1:30. We don't have. Okay. We'll decide. We'll speak later. Okay, regarding this timing. Okay. Okay, Pavan, any questions? Okay, your whole room. Yeah, I remember Pavan. Okay, you can continue the sessions in this batch. No problem. Okay, thank you. Okay, Pavan. Okay, next, Prabhakar, any questions? Prabhakar. Next, Prasad, somebody join with the name Prasad. Next, oh sorry, yeah, CSA compulsory, yeah, it's mandatory case. So at least CSA you have to do. So leave it CSA. No, everyone will not ask for CSA. So you have to compulsory do the CSA certification. Next, Prabhakar, Praveen Kumar Durgam, any questions? Next, Raji Ritvik. Yes, tell me, Prabhakar. Yeah, I can hear you. Okay. Okay, no problem. Okay. Okay. Okay, fine. Not an issue. I'll provide the assistance only. Yeah, I will be there. I will be giving the projects only. Okay. Yeah, you can contact me anytime through mail support or phone support. I will give them. Okay, if you are unable to understand in this batch, you can join another batch also. Suppose if you missed most of the sessions, I will allow you in some other batch also, not any. Suppose. Yeah, recordings you'll get anyway. Okay, your Prabhakar, your email ID. RVMP. Okay. Three times. Okay, two times. Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Next, Praveen. Okay, fine. Thank you. Praveen, any questions? Yes, yeah, I can hear you. Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay. Okay, fine. Okay. Yeah, previous version. Yeah, certifications for 6.3 and all. Yeah. Okay, now again you can do the CSS 7.1, not an issue. So because once again you have to do the CSA for 7.1 version. Okay, not 2 years. You can easily manage 3 to 4 years also. Anyways, not a problem. Yes, sir. So real-time applications, I cannot take the entire project, right? I will be taking some part of domains, so which covers all the rules, like so how to use data model rules, user interface rules, activity rules, so like all the rules will be covered. Okay, so decision rules, declarative rules, so first notification, process rules. Yeah, explaining each and yeah, activity rules, because every session will define separate different activities, so which covers all the scenarios. Okay, so maximum every session is a practical session. Yeah, I will explain each and every method, every parameter. Okay, so with practicals we will see calling activities in different ways. Yeah, tracer and all clipboard will use daily. Yeah, tracer and clipboard, so all the things will be part of the training process. Okay, I will share the okay. Yeah, no. Okay, no problem. Yeah, you can join in next batch also, not an issue. Yeah, dates I will provide. Okay, your email ID. Okay. Okay. I think I already. Okay, fine. Yes. Okay, thank you. Next. Raji, any questions? Yes, tell me. Okay. Yeah, yes, I can hear you. Okay. Okay. Chennai also openings are there. Yeah, within Chennai also openings are there. Not an issue. In Chennai, contacts are not there because no need to, because in India not required concerns contacts. If you apply in the portal, automatically you'll get the calls from so many. So the third party companies will be there. So you'll directly get the calls and interview will get scheduled. So no need to, because here not required, in India not required. So directly if you upload in the portal, so you'll get the calls automatically. Yeah, so most for Pega maximum compulsory, if you work on 1 year or 2 years, you'll compulsory get on-site offers. Chance will be more on Pega for Pega professionals. Okay, it's sufficient. Yeah, minimum 2 is sufficient. If you want to apply for a Pega profile, minimum 2, maximum up to 10, not issue. Okay. Okay, Ritvik, any questions? Okay, Raji, your email ID. Rajiv. Okay. 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 56 or 66? Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Next, Ritvik. Okay, fine. Okay. Next, Satya Jagadish. Yeah, hi. Yes. Okay. Okay. Oh, no need to have any knowledge on that, because we will not do any changes or modifications. So just in the runtime it will generate the code in the backend. In the previous versions means we need to have some knowledge, but in the current version not required. That depends upon company to company. Okay, so if like more than 2 years means you have to recertify. Okay, and within 1 year, if you join the project in new company, so you already last one year you did the certification is not required. If more than 2 years or 2.5 years, so they will, if they have a requirement, you have to do. Okay. Okay, fine. Okay. Yes. Next, Sivanand, any questions? Ah, yes, Sivanand, yes, tell me. Okay. Yeah, IJPs will be there. If any company is having this Pega, that's the thing that you are asking. IJPs. Yeah, so many. Yeah, if you do the certification, they'll give you a chance. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, it's possible. It's possible, not an issue. Not required. So you'll keep the just previous experience, you'll keep on Pega and you'll move. Okay, no problem. Okay, fine. Thank you. Next, Sojanya, any questions? Okay, Neelima. Okay, tell me. Okay, fine. Okay. Okay. Okay, your email ID or your coordinator? Who is your coordinator? Ashok. Okay, fine. I will take from you. Next, Sudhir, any questions? Okay, fine. Okay, Sudhir, your email ID? Ashok, okay, then I'll take finish. Next, Vandana. Okay. Okay. Okay, not a problem. So if you have the finance, you can keep a project on finance domain, you can switch to peers. Not an issue then. Home basic it will not support. Starter and home basic. Okay, whether it is 32-bit or 64-bit. No, I'm asking 64-bit, right? We can give a try. Sometimes it will work and sometimes it won't work. First of all, we can give a try. So 64-bit, right? Not an issue. It will install. If it is a starter version, it will not install. Or 32-bit means it will not install. If it is 64-bit, we can give a try. If not, then you can try to install any other Windows 7 Ultimate or some other version and you can check. The Pega, sorry, Pega. Yeah, then it's a full application only. Yeah, you can use it anytime. No, there will not be any limitations. So it's a full version. So anytime you can access. So once you've installed in your system. Okay. Yes, on daily basis. After the session, you'll get the recording. And that one, once if you download, it will be file will be there, right? So it will be for I will be sending from the send space. So if you download immediately, it will be there. So the file will be there permanently. It's like a MP4 file or MP3 file, it will be, right? So once if you download the file, it will be there permanently, right? So like you can save it in a system as a dump file. So and you can use anytime after 20 years, 15 years also you can use. Okay. So but what are the link I share, right? You have to download immediately, like within month you have to download. Okay, fine. Next, Vasundhara, any questions? Okay, fine. Okay, you are from Ashok. Okay, fine. Okay, next to Vijay, any questions? So daily 6 to 7:15 or 7:30, 6 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. Means next to batch you're asking. Okay. By March ending it will be done. Okay, fine. Okay, Vijay, you are from? Any coordinator name? Jyoti. Okay, fine. Okay. Next, Yuga. Some Yugandar or Yuga. Yeah, I can hear you. Okay. So it will be, it looks same how you are seeing the part in personal edition. It will be same. I'll show the deployment and all, I will show you. Okay. Yeah, from scratch you are going to learn. Yes. Okay, fine. Okay, we can also see in the personal edition also, right? So once we develop a project on the main. So okay, if you want I can show you, not a problem. Okay. Okay, coming to Pega, it will be like rule, based on the rules they will ask. Okay, suppose you will keep some responsibilities, like what the answer you get, the next question will be based on the topic. So here, logically, there will not be any questions there. So based on the means, how the steps will be for this rule, how you will implement, how when you will use this rule in the application. Like this, rule-wise, the questions will be there. Okay, that one, once if you cover the all the practical sessions and the Pega help file will be there. If you cover all the contents, you can answer any interview question. So mostly they will ask the differences. For example, methods will be there. Okay, what is the difference between this method and that method? okay, what is the difference between, can you use the rule in this particular rule or not, like this. So once we done the practical, so practically the questions will be there on Pega PRPC only. Within that tool only you'll get the questions. Okay. Okay. Yeah, you can take it. Yeah, you can take it. Not an issue. Yeah, will be covered here. So mostly they'll ask the steps, means how this particular task can be done. So tell me the steps for that. Most of the questions will be like that, and just basic questions also they will ask. So we will cover all the things. Okay. You are from your coordinator Ashok or Joe? Okay, fine. Okay, your email ID once, can you? Okay, then others, any questions? Okay, so next session, the regular classes will start from Tuesday. Yes, Praveen, tell me. Yeah, job assistance you'll be getting. Yeah, separate charges will be there. So it depends upon through consultancy if you want to go, means so they will take care of the things. Okay. So if you want to try by your own means, you can contact me or anyone. Resume preparation will be done by me. Okay, so the link will be same for the next session also. So which will be on Tuesday 6 a.m. IST. So from Tuesday regular classes will be there. So daily. So for the US students it will be Monday evening. Okay. So the link is same for the next sessions also. Okay. So after the Tuesday session I will be sharing the software and everything. Okay, so thank you guys, thank you everyone. Any issues, I will share the recording of the session and course content and all. If you have any questions, you can mail me this. Okay, so thank you, we'll see in the next week. I have taken your ID, right? I'll share it. Okay. Thank you everyone.